Good afternoon, students. So last class, last lab class, we have demonstrated three shift instructions. So next I am going to explain rotate right and rotate right extended instruction. So according to your ARM cortex architecture, we have a three shift instruction, that is logical shift left, logical shift right, and arithmetic shift right. Okay, so logical shift left means multiply the register content by 2 power of n. Okay, so here n specifies the number of bits. For example, LSL #5 means the register content is multiplied by 32, which means 2 power of 5. Okay, and here 0 is inserted at the LSB and bits are shifted towards left, and your last bit, 31st bit, is placed into carry. Okay, and next, the logical shift right, so it multiplies the register, that is divides the register content by 2 power of n. N specifies number of shifts. For example, LSR #5 means it is used to divide the register content by 2 power of 5, which means divide by 32. Here 0 is inserted at MSB and bits are shifted towards right, and your last bit D0 is placed into carry. Okay, and next one is the arithmetic shift right. Actually, this is mainly used for your two's complement operations. Okay, so this will preserve the this will preserve the signed bit, that is your 31st bit. So it will preserve the 31st bit and propagate the signed bit to the next bit, that is 30th bit. Likewise, 32, 29 towards right direction, and your last bit D0 is placed into carry. Okay, so rotate right instruction, actually in this case, is used to rotate each bit of the register by specified amount. Okay, so your last bit D0 is placed in carry as well as in 31st bit, and bits are rotated towards right direction. Okay, so bits are removed from one end of the register and inserted into the other end. Okay, and rotate right extended, here we can perform only one rotation. We cannot specify the number of rotation in the instruction. Okay, so here your D0 is placed into carry, and carry to 31st bit, and bits are rotated towards right direction. Okay, so this allows 32 bit rotation by using register and the carry flag, register plus carry. So only one time rotation is allowed in case of rotate right extended. Okay, so any doubts regarding your parallel shift operations? So have you completed your logical shift left, right, and arithmetic shift right? Have you all completed? Have you executed the code in your KL Microvision?
See, unmute and answer no.
Yes, ma'am.
Got the output for all your shift operations? Any clarifications, any doubts you have, students? Please respond. Do you have any doubts,
ma'am?
Yes,
ma'am. It throws some error, ma'am.
Can you project your screen, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. One second.
Okay, ma'am.
என்ன எரர் இமீடியட் வேல்யூ 0x h கொடுத்து பாருங்க அட் தி எண்ட் ஆஃப் தி வேர்ட் எரர் போச்சா இல்ல தேர் இஸ் அ ப்ராப்ளம் இன் யுவர் அசம்பிளிங் சி எக்ஸ்பிரிமெண்ட் 2.a 0 எரர் 0 வார்னிங் சோ தேர் வாஸ் அ ப்ராப்ளம் இன் யுவர் ப்ராஜெக்ட் கிரியேஷன்
மேம் டூ ஃபைல்ஸ் ஆர் ஆடட் இன் தி சோர்ஸ்
ஆ டூ ஃபைல்ஸ் ஆர் ஆடட் ஜஸ்ட் யூ ரிமூவ் தட் ஃபைல்
யூ ஹேவ் ஒன்லி தி
ஆட் டாட் எஸ் ரைட் கிளிக் ஆட் டாட் எஸ் அண்ட் ரிமூவ் தட் ஃபைல்
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Actually, your file is successfully compiled. So remove that r.s. Your experiment name is experiment 2.a. No, just you right click add.s. No, here under source group 1, under source group 1, right click, remove file add.s. Okay, click. Now compile. Okay. Again.
No, again same error, ma'am.
No, R not comma. Okay, click the next icon. Next debug icon. Your target is not created.
See change ma'am and the value MSP sign vittirukanaaleyo sometimes varum nenikira and 8 ku badala give 7
positions the idu paakanum inga dyna paakanga parunga you have to check the position settings inga code adupa sollama inga ponna ipa pathina final end la vandu there are no errors No error, zero warning.
So now try to compile. Click the next icon.
So how many digits?
Ma'am, R not can have only 8-bit register, no ma'am.
Ah, low
bit.
Register, huh?
She has given 32-bit, like.
Give 4 digits, ma'am. Remove remaining digits.
Okay, ma'am.
Now compile. That is the problem. So for 32 bit number you have to use higher order registers okay
okay ma'am
For lower order, you have to load only 16-bit volume. For low registers, you have to load 16-bit values, hex values.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. So, any other clarifications?
Ma'am, in output format, we have given 32-bit, no, ma'am. Let them do manually, no, ma'am.
Yes, Pradipa. Mm-hmm. Instead of that, they can use higher order registers.
Okay.
R7 to R11. Any other doubts? Shall we move on to the rotate instruction program?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See. So I have included two rotate right instruction and two rotate right extended instruction. So this is ROR is.
Ma'am, screen sharing, ma'am.
See, I have included two rotate right instruction. The first one is the rotate right without flag update, okay? And next one is the rotate right SS with flag update. Similarly, RRX, rotate right extended without flag updation. And RRX is the rotate right extended with flag updation, okay? So the first instruction, your 09 is transferred to R0. So look at this table, your R0 holds 09, okay? So what is the second instruction? Move R1 comma hash 0x25C3. So this instruction is used to move 16-bit hex value into lower half word of R1. So the 16-bit value is transferred to R1. So this is your lower half word, okay? And next, move R3 comma hash 0x73A2, okay? So this instruction is used to move 16-bit hex value to the lower half word of R3. That is R3, after execution of this instruction, your R3 holds 73A2 alone, only it holds 16-bit value. So next, I am using move top instruction. What is the purpose of move top? So what is the operation of move top instruction? So after execution of move top, what will be the content of your R3? Please tell me.
Please unmute and tell or put it in the chat.
5D817382, ma'am.
5D81
and 7382.
382, very good. Actually, this instruction is used to move the 16-bit hex value to the upper half word of R3. Okay. So after execution of move top, your R3 holds this one. That is 5D817382. So these two half words are combined by using this move top instruction. So after execution, your R3 holds this value, okay? So what is the first instruction, rotate instruction? ROR, R2, R1, hash 24. So this instruction is used to move all the bits of register, that is R1 register, by 24, okay? So 24 times the R1 content be rotated, okay? So this instruction is rotate right without flag update, okay? You don't consider the flag updation here, okay? So what is the operation of your rotate right? Your LSB is copied into carry, and also your the knot is placed in 31st bit and bits are shifted towards right. So after execution, that is after the 24th bit rotation, the answer is this one. D12E30B8, okay? So after execution, your carry is, suppose if you are using RORS, your carry is resetted, okay? So what is the next instruction? RORS, R4, R3, R0. Your R0 holds 09, okay? So how many rotations to be performed here in this case? RORS, R4, R3, R0. So rotate right with flag update. So rotate right by 9 bits with flag update. So that is the meaning of that instruction. So your R3 content is 5D817382. So this one is shifted towards right by how many times? 9 times. Because your R0 holds 9, okay? So this is your second rotation. The ninth rotation, your R4 holds this value. So previous case, R2 holds result, and ROS, R4 holds this value. Okay, what is the value? D12EC0B9. So after execution, your carry will be set. Okay. So next one is the rotate right extended without flag update. So R5, R3. So it will provide only one rotation. So this instruction allows 32-bit rotation, okay? So before execution, your carry is set to 1. After execution, your carry is set to 0. And this will be your answer after the rotate right extended instruction. Your R6 holds this answer. Okay. So here your 0 is placed into carry. Okay. And 1 is placed in 31st bit. And bits are rotated towards right by 1 time. Okay, is that clear? Any doubts? See, do you have any doubts? I'm asking you only.
One has replied in chat. It's clear. Please, all of you, please answer now. Reply. Please unmute and answer, okay?
So next, I'm going to simulate this code in Kale Microvision. So, 09, first load 09 into R0. And 25C3 into R1 and 73A2 into R3 and 5D81 into R3. There is move top instruction. Perform rotate right with flag update and without flag update. And next rotate right extend without flag update and with flag update. Okay. So 09 is loaded into R0. So look at here, register window, 09 is loaded into R0. And next I am going to execute the next instruction. So your R1 is loaded this value 25C3, okay. And next your R3 is loaded with 7382. So what will be the next instruction? Next instruction is move top instruction. So after execution of move top instruction, your R3 holds 32-bit value, okay. That is, it combines both the 16-bit words. So your R3 holds this 32-bit value. And before execution, you clear this carry. Before execution of your ROR, clear this carry flag. After that, you check the results. So after execution, see here. So after execution, your R2 holds result and your carry is resetted. That is, carry is equal to zero. Okay. So now the carry is zero. Okay. So this is rotate right without flag update. Okay. So next, rotate right with flag update. Here, you look at here. After execution of RORS, the carry is set, okay? And execute the rotate right extended instruction. After execution, your R5 holds the result, okay? And carry is reset. That is, carry is set to 1, okay? Carry is set to 1. Next, after execution of RRX, your R6 holds the result. According to the result, your carry is resetted, okay? In this way, you can check your carry and also without carry using rotate right and rotate right extended instruction. Any doubts? Students, be interactive. Any clarifications? Okay. Pradeepa?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
So, the screen is visible. Yes ma'am. Okay. So, this week we will see the array handling operations using the ARM Cortex. Okay. So, here we will discuss about the addition of 4 numbers in an array, number of positive and negative numbers in an array, sum of n numbers, and addition of array elements. Okay, so first experiment we will just discuss on adding 4 numbers. So if you look into the algorithm, so first we need to have the 4 numbers. So we should get the input data and let it be assigned as x1, x2, x3 and x4. So we need to load those values into the corresponding data registers. So because we can do the processing with the data registers only. So we have to load the data from the register, that is from the variable, into the registers. Then we have to perform the addition of the 4 different numbers. And the result should be stored in any one of the register. So we will see instruction is helping us in loading the data from the variable into the register. Okay. So we have the LDR register, which is a load data register. Suppose you want to load the data from the memory. That means you are reading from the memory If it is an 8-bit unsigned number, then you can use this instruction LDRB, load data register byte. Okay, and this is load data register signed byte. Similarly, for 16-bit, you have a half word H, signed half word for your unsigned number. If it is a direct 32-bit data you have to read from the memory, then you can use the instruction LDR. If you want to read multiple 32-bit data, then you can use the instruction LDM. For double word, it is LDRD. And for stack related operations, you have push and pop instructions. Okay, so load is used to read the data from the memory. In the other way, some data operations you are doing, you are performing some operations, and the result has to be put back into the memory. So for that, we have the store register, I mean store instructions. So STR is used to refer to the store instruction, which is used to write the data into the memory. Okay, so similarly for all the data type, we have the different instructions. So if you look into how we use the instruction, we can refer or represent the instruction followed by the destination register and the source register. So if you are representing within the square bracket, it means, for example, if I am writing it as R0 within the square bracket, so it is referring to like a pointer. The base address of the R0 is taken, and this square bracket represents you are accessing the data from that address. Okay? So it's similar to your pointers in your C, where your R0 represents the address and you're accessing the star operator with the pointer, right? The same way here we use the square bracket to read the data from the memory location. So you will go to that memory location and that data will be read and it will be loaded into the RD register. Okay, similarly, you have an hash offset, which means the register, the base address is given. With that base address, you can move to some other location. For example, 10 is my address. If I want to move to 12, so I can give it as hash 2, which means this base address plus 2, which will be taking to that address, and that data in that specific address will be moved into the destination register. So similarly, you have for all the load and store instructions to access the data from the base address. So we will use this square bracket. This offset value is an optional one. If you don't represent this value by default, it will be zero. Okay. So now coming to our example. So we are trying to add 4 numbers. So let us take the 4 numbers as 4, 5, 8 and 15, the decimal values. So what we are doing, I'm representing that in hexadecimal. Okay, so here it is 4, 5, 8 and F. So what we have to perform is 4 is to be added with 5, then that result 9 is to be added with 8, 17, 17 plus 15, which is 32 in decimal. So the equivalent hexadecimal is hex 20. So we don't have direct operation like add 4 numbers. Okay, so what we have to do is we have to apply our algorithm. So first you have to, you have loaded the numbers in 4 different registers. So first what we will do is we will add these 2 registers, R0 data and R1 data, and we will have the result in R0. Okay, next with these 2 result added result, you can now add the R2 value. Okay, so with this result, again you will update in R0. So now the data will be 17 here. So with 17, you can add your R3. So finally, the result will be in the R0 register. Okay, so we will see how to write this in the coding. So here we will declare the, use the directive EQU. What is this EQU representing? Can anyone answer? Can anyone answer?
To give symbols to the numbers.
Symbols. You are assigning the value 4 to?
To a variable. X1.
A variable. It's like an equal to. Okay. So X1. X1 equals 4, which means 4 is assigned to X1 and 5 is assigned to X2. 8 is assigned to X3 and 15 is assigned to X4. If you are not representing any base, it is by default the decimal. Okay. If you want the hexadecimal, then you can represent it as 0x. Okay. So here you are declaring all these things in the data memory. The data. Okay. Next, what we are doing, we are starting the coding. So here, this is all the structure of your ARM cortex. So in the main logic, what we are doing, so we are using the LDR instruction. What is the use of LDR instruction here? Load the data into the register. So this data, so here we are not specifying the memory location. Instead, what we are doing, we are directly taking the value, the X1 variable. So equal to X1 means, so what is this X1 is now assigned with? Is 4. Okay, so this 4 is now moved into R0. So after the execution of this instruction, R0 will be loaded with the value 4. Similarly, your R1 is now loaded with what? The X2 value. What is this X2? X2 will have an base address and that is having the value as 5. So this 5 will be now moved into your register R1. Next instruction, what we are doing, LDR R2 equal to comma equal to X3, which means X3 value will be assigned into your R2. So here R2 will be assigned with 8. And the fourth instruction, R3 is now assigned with 15. So here what we are doing next, we are trying to add R0 plus R1, and what we are doing, where is the result stored back? It is stored back in R0 itself. So now what is the value you have in R0? It is 4. 4 and 5 is added, and now after the execution of this instruction, R0 will be updated with the value 9. And next, if you write add R0, R2, R0 is now 9. Okay, so R0 and R2 are added. What will get? So 9 is added with 8 and you will be getting 17. Okay, so next what you have? So it is in hexadecimal, it will be 1 1. Okay. After the execution of the last statement, what you will get? R0 is equal to R0 plus R3. R0 and R3 are now added, and where is the result stored? Say R0. So if you look into this, so 11 hex plus your R3 is 15, which is F in hex. So it will be what? F plus 1. What is F plus 1? Or 17 plus 15? This 32 in decimal. F plus 1 is what? 0 with the carry, right? So 0 with the carry. So 1 plus 1, 2 in hexadecimal. Got it? So let us see how it is executed. So I have already created the project and I have saved it with the file add 4 numbers. Let me add the project here. Mm-hmm. we will compile it. So I'll keep the breakpoint. So we will move into the debugging mode. So you can see that first instruction is executed. R0 is loaded with 4. The next instruction is executed. R1 is loaded with 5. R2 is loaded with 8. And R3 is now loaded with F, hex value. Okay. So now what is our first instruction? So we have added R0 with R1 and the result is updated in R0. The value 9 is added. 4 plus 5, 9 is obtained in R0. After the next execution, so 9 with 8 is giving 17 in decimal, which is 11 in hex. So with that, what we are doing, we are adding 15, so which is 32 in decimal. So in hex, it is 20. Is it clear for all of you? Any doubts you have in this program? Because this will be acting as a base for your array addition, which we will be telling you only the algorithm. You have to try yourself. Any doubts you have on here? Is it clear? Okay, ma'am, we'll move on to the next one. So the next in coding is, we will see how to identify the number of positive and number of negative numbers in a given array. Okay. So before going into the algorithm, we should also know some branch instructions. Suppose we are checking some condition, if else. It's a kind of if else. If it is true, we have to go to some portion, some part of the task. If it is not true, we have to do certain other task. So here the branch instructions help us in doing that. So this instruction is with the letter capital B, that is B followed by the condition. So the condition can be equal to, not equal to, like a carry set, clear, minus, plus, overflow, no overflow. So here you will have the suffix given here. This will be the conditional instructions. So with the prefix B, if you use, it will be the branch instructions. For example, here you can see that BEQ, they have given some label for the function loop. Okay. So if it is so, if branch equal, if R0 is equal to, so here before that you are comparing, compare instruction is done, CMP R0 comma hash 1. So R0 is compared with 1. So you are branching, you are checking BEQ, which means that branch to this loop, to this portion, if your R0 is equal to R1. Okay. So you are trying to divert or make the program counter move to the other location when the condition is true. So similarly, if it is BNE, it is branch not equal, which means your zero flag is not set. So if it is equal, then the zero flag is set. So likewise, you have suffix and the branch condition and corresponding flags which are set. So here you can see this MI, which means it is a minus or a negative. If you write BMI, which means it is a branch if minus. So in that case, negative flag is set. If it is PL, it is a positive or a plus. So in that case, your N flag will be cleared. So if you want to compare the numbers to be greater than or less than, you can use your GT, which is your signed greater than, and GE if it is a signed greater than or equal. And for less than equal, so less than you have LT, less than or equal to you have LE. Okay, so here we can use these branch conditions for our next program. So how to find the positive and negative numbers in an array? Any idea of how we can find whether the given number is a positive number or a negative number? Which bit decides the given number is a positive number or a negative number? Which bit of the given 32-bit number will tell whether the given number is positive or negative? So MSB bit, okay, good. So your MSB bit is 0, it means positive number or a negative number? Tell me what, if your MSB bit is 0, what number it is? If your MSB bit is 1, what number it is? So if it is 0, it is positive. If your MSB is 1, it means it is a negative number. Okay, so we will use that logic here. So first what we will do is, since we are operating with array, so we have to initialize the values. So first what we are doing, we are going to load the base address of the array. So array is somewhere, say your array is X. So this array will have a base address. That address has to be loaded into some register. Okay, so that is to be done first. And before that, we will have the value in the array. We will assign some positive numbers and some negative numbers in the array. Okay, so after that, what we are doing, we have to check the MSB bit, whether it is 1 or 0. So out of the 32-bit information, so this MSB bit is to be checked. So what I'm doing, I'm setting only that bit as 1 and I'm making all other bits as 0. So which means what? The equivalent hexadecimal number for a 32-bit number will be 8 followed by 7 zeros. Okay, which means only your MSB bit is 1. So if I'm doing a simple AND operation, I can find whether the given number is a positive number or a negative number. If the AND value is 1, it means it is a negative number. If the AND value is, suppose my input is 0. So if it is 0, then it means the given number is a positive number. So this logic we are going to adapt. So what I am doing here, so I will use a counter register to access the number of elements. So this X contains, say for example, some numbers up to some N numbers you will have. Okay, so what I'm doing, I will initialize a counter to access the given number N, the number of elements in an array, and I will load the value 8 followed by 7 zeros in one temporary register. So what I will do is, I will perform an AND operation and I will compare the value. When it is 0, I will count, I will have one variable for positive number, and for negative number I will have another variable negative. So what I will do, I will have two different registers here. So I have to increment the positive register when the value is not 0. So if 0 flag is not set, increment the register, which is you have to count for the negative. So if 0 flag is not set, it means you have to increment the negative number. Otherwise, what you have to do, you have to increase the positive number. So you have else increment the register to count the number of positive. So parallelly, what we should do, we should decrement the count value. N you have no number of elements is there, so you have to scan through all the numbers. So in the, for that case, you are decrementing the value of N. So you have to repeat this task until you are scanned with all the elements in an array. Suppose my N is equal to 10. Okay, so what will I do? I will start with the first number. So after completing the first number, I have to decrement the value of 10 to 9. So for that we are doing this decrement the count register and jump to step 5. So again we will load the next data. So we have taken the first data, we have performed AND operation, we have updated positive or negative, then we have decremented the count. Next, what we are doing, we are taking the second data, perform AND operation, check whether it is a positive or negative, update the variable, then decrement the value. So you continue until the count becomes zero. So repeat the steps, becomes zero. Okay, so once the count has become zero, we will stop the program. Okay, so how to initialize the beginning of the program, we will see in the program. Okay, so this is just one data I've taken. If the input is 32-bit number 11223343 in hexadecimal, I've taken the binary number and you're adding the results.
Students, this number is positive or negative? Can unmute and answer the input, given input? Positive. Okay. So basically the logic is load a register with the value of 8 along with 7 zeros. Okay. And the 31st bit is 1 means the number is the negative number, otherwise positive number. So get the array element and load it in a temporary register. Okay. Perform AND operation. So you have to get the element one by one from the array and perform the AND operation with this value. Okay. And this step is used to check the 31st bit. Okay. Suppose if both are 1, what is the answer after AND operation? Can you understand my question? Your input 31st bit is 1. Adding with 8 with 7 zeros. What is the answer? What is the answer after AND operation? Pradipa, எழுதி காமி பிரதீபா, உங்களுக்கு புரியுதான்னு பார்க்கலாம். அதாவது இன்புட் இஸ் தட் இஸ் 31st பிட் இஸ் 1. 1 வித் சம் வேல்யூஸ் அண்ட் வித் 8000. வாட் இஸ் த ஆன்சர்
ஆஃப்டர் ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் இஃப் யூ டேக் திஸ் வேல்யூ EDCBA98E. So here the MSB bit here is 1. So I have written the other values. So you are ANDing this with 10000. So this bit AND with this will give you your MSB bit as
1.
Whereas in the previous case, if it is bit is 0 AND with 1, the MSB bit here is 0.
Okay. So after AND operation, you need to check the zero flag. So that is the logic here. So your 31st bit is 1 means your zero flag is not set. Okay. So increment the number of negative counts. Otherwise, increment the number of positive counts. That's all. You can proceed, Pradipa.
Okay.
Students, is that clear?
Is it clear? Okay. So we will see the coding, how we will write the count the number of positive and negative numbers in an array. So first what we have to do is we have to initialize the array. Okay. So the array consists of the following 10 numbers. So how we are assigning is using this instruction DCD. So this is nothing but the data which is assigned to the data memory. Okay. So here we have the double word, which means it's a 32-bit data. Okay. So if you are giving a double word, then you have to use this word. D. If I'm writing it as DCB, it can access. So DCD is a data with double word is assigned to the array. Is this a positive number or a negative number? Please unmute and tell no. Register number 70. Please unmute and tell no whether this number is a positive number or a negative number.
Ma'am.
Is this a positive or a negative number, ma'am?
Negative, ma'am.
Why is it negative? Can you justify?
MSB is 1.
So here MSB is a hexadecimal number. How you will represent a hexadecimal number in binary? You have to represent, no?
Yes, ma'am.
So how you will represent this as a 32-bit number? 0001. Yes? Again,
yes,
it is 0001.
So positive, positive.
Now tell me whether the given clear all of you.
Positive.
You go. Please be clear that this is the hexadecimal number which will be in the binary form. You have to check only the MSB bit in the binary form, the 31st bit. Okay, so this is a positive number. And if I'm representing like this, minus 0x some number, what will happen? What will be the value assigned to the register? Number 75 is here. It's not here. So anyone?
Ma'am, what is complement?
Yes, exactly. So for this number, 2's complement will be taken and that value will be assigned to the register because we have a negative sign. Okay. So it is a negative number. So this will be again a positive number, a negative number, a negative number. So here it is A, 1010. Okay, so again here this will be a negative number. So by representing this negative, we cannot directly take this as a negative number. Okay, so we should always take the 2's complement of that number and see if that MSB bit is 1. Only in that case we can take it as a negative number. Okay, so we are assigning 10 numbers in the array. So next what I'm doing, I need to AND with some AND the data with the 8 followed by 7 zeros hexadecimal. So that I am assigning to a variable N. So N DCD hex 870s. So then these are global initialization. So now we are moving into the logic, main logic. So what I'm doing, I'm loading into the R5 register this data 8 followed by 7x into your R5 register, which means that every data has to be taken in the array and it is to be ANDed with this R5 register and the result has to be compared. So R1 is equal to array means the base address of this array. This array is having some base address, so that address will be now loaded into the R1. Okay, so I'm moving one more register, R2, which represents the number of elements in the array. So I have 10 elements in the array, so I'm loading it as hex 0a. okay, so R2 is now with 10 elements, 10 number 10. And next what are we, LDR not comma content of R5. Where is this R5? In some location. So it is pointing to the address of N. Okay. So address of n is taken. So if I'm putting it in square bracket, which means the content represented in that address will be referred. So this n base address is referred in R5, and that content is what? This 8 and followed by 7 zeros. So this will be now moved into R0 register. This is how you are access using your load data register. Okay. Next, what we are doing, the content of R1. So R1 is now pointing to the base address of this array. So the content in the R1 is now pointing to the first element, because always the base address points to the first element in the array. Okay. So this is loaded into the R4 register. So we have taken the R0 with this value and R4 pointing to the first data. Next, what we should do, we should perform the AND operation between your R0 and R4. So what happens? So this data is taken and it is ANDed with 1000. So what will be the result here? The AND operation will result in all zeros, which means it is a zero flag is set now. Okay. So now what we are doing, we are adding R1 plus, I mean with R1 comma hash 4. So where is this R1 pointing to? What is this R1 pointing to? It is referring to the base address here. So for example, my base address is 4. Example I'm taking, my base address is 4. So why I am incrementing this by again 4?
Next element is taken.
What now?
The next element from the array is taken.
Yes, next element has to be taken. I can just increment by 1, no? Why I'm incrementing by 4? So this array has 1. So this is my first data. So it is in address is pointing to 8. Why is that I am pointing to 8? I'm asking. So here it is because 32-bit register, each can have only 8-bit information, right? So we have to increment by 4 bytes. Only then we can access the second data. If you simply write increment by 1, it will not be corresponding to the second element.
Okay. I would like to add some more points.
Yes, ma'am.
Actually, according to your pipeline characteristics of ARM Cortex M4, the current memory pointer is added with 4, okay, to fetch the next data from the memory, okay? Since we are handling 32-bit operations, so your current program memory, that is memory pointer, is added with 4 to fetch the next data from the memory. So that is the concept, okay? So based on your pipeline characteristics, the memory pointer value will be changed, okay? Sometimes PC plus program counter plus 4, for some cases we can include, that is we can add 8 with program counter. So that is completely based on your pipeline characteristics, okay?
Okay, ma'am. So you are pointing to the next data, okay, by incrementing the register R1 by 4 bytes. So next data will be pointed. So now we are comparing whether your R0 is 0. What is your R0? R0 is nothing but the content of R5, which is, that is the ANDed result. Okay, so here we have got all zeros. So comparing whether it is 0. So then what we are doing, the increment of positive element, that is the positive value in the R3 register, and if it is a negative number, you are incrementing in the R6 register. So this add PL and add MI, which means it is a minus and it is a positive one. Okay. So if your zero flag is set, it means what? It is a positive number. Okay. So if it is set, this PL will be added. If it is a negative number, this R6 will be added. So after updating the positive number or a negative number, what we should do? We should subtract the count. So where is the count? Count is in register R2. So you are subtracting R2 with the status flag and you are decrementing by 1. So sum is R2, R2, hash 1. So it is R2 is equal to R2 minus 1. So then what we should do? We should check whether the value has become equal to 0 or not. So if the value is not equal to 0, that means zero flag is not set, then where I'm branching, I'm asking to go to myglue. So this means the control again transfer to this point. So again, these statements will be executed until your R2 value turns to 0 and zero flag is set. So the zero flag is now controlling, or it is branching to the location. So here that's as a looping. The looping is executed. Okay. Any doubt in this coding? I'll show you the demo. We'll remove this project. I'll save this. I'll add the project. So I'll compile it. I'll set the breakpoint. We'll move on to the debug mode. So now you can see this R5 is now loaded with the address of the, what is this R5 pointing to? The address of the value N. Okay, so this address is only loaded. Next, what we are loading? R1 base address of this array is loaded. Okay. So next, what we are loading, R2 is loaded with an immediate value A. So R2 is updated with A. Next, content in R5. So the content in the earlier address is now taken. So the data content is 8 followed by 70. So that is loaded now only into the R0 register. Next, what we are doing, we are loading the R4 with the content of R1, which means it is the first data. Okay, so the first data is now loaded into the R4 register. We are performing AND operation, and that AND result is loaded in R0. So if you perform, they all bits are 0. Next, what happens? Your R1 is incremented with 4. So you can see that the address earlier it was 250, so here it is 254 now. Okay, so next we are doing, we are comparing your R0 with the value 0. So you can see that it is 0 flag is 1 because we had the AND operated result. So you are now comparing R0 with 0. So it is not 0, not equal 0. So what R3 is positive number. So R3 is now added with 1 since the AND output was a 0. Okay. So it continues. So the second data is now taken. It has to subtract, right? So R2 is now subtracted by 1. So earlier it was 10. So 10 minus 1, 9 is loaded into the R2 register. Next, what happens? It's checking whether it is not equal or equal. Okay, so not equal, that means zero flag is not set. So it is not equal. So what happens? Branching moves into the second. So what happens? Second data is now loaded. What is the second data? It's the negative 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 2. So the 2's complement number is EDC BA980. So E means it's a MSB bit is 1. So let us see whether your R6 register is incrementing. So I'll just continue. We'll fastly run it. So you can see R6 register is now incremented because it is a negative number. So your MSB bit is 1. So your AND result was also 8 followed by 70. And you can see that the program counter, I mean the R1 register is incremented by 4 to point to the next data. You can see the next data is to be loaded, and R2 register is also decremented by 1. So next, what happens? Next data is loaded. So AND operation is performed. It's a positive number. So R1 is incremented by 4. We are checking whether the value is positive or negative. It's a positive number, so you're updating in the positive value, decrementing the count. And so you're performing the, you're continuing the loop, okay? We can see that R2 is now decremented. So until it becomes zero, we have to continue the operation. We can see R2 is now 1. The last case is going on, it's negative number. So you can see that once it is zero, so the branch will stop after this. Okay, so R2 has turned zero and it has come out of the loop and it is in. So you can see that in this given set of array, you find 5 positive numbers and 5 negative numbers. Okay, is this clear for all of you? Any doubts you have? Any doubts?
Difference between DCD and DCB.
DCD and?
DCB.
It is a byte or a double word. It's whether the data is a 32-bit word or it is a 8-bit word. I mean 8-bit data.
So DCD means define constant data.
Ma'am,
Pradipa.
Ma'am, next to the point, ma'am.
Ipo idha vandu execute pantiya Pradipa?
Yes, ma'am.
Execute paniyaachilla. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Appa ni rendu logic explain pannita avangala panna sollirlam.
Okay, ma'am.
Logic PPT la logic matte explain pannu.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
So the next coding is sum of n numbers. Okay. So earlier, the first coding what we did, we just added only 4 numbers. So now what I'm we are asking you to do is, you have a count. So based on the count, the number of elements has to be added. That means starting from 1. So 1, 2, 3 up to n. So you have to add n numbers. Okay? So if my n is 5. Then you should perform 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. If n is 10, you should perform 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus up to 10. Okay, starting from 1 till n you have to do the addition, and that result has to be displayed or it has to be given out. Okay, so the algorithm here is how you can do is you can initialize the count value, okay, and you initialize the sum as a zero, and the number of elements depends on the count only. So you can load this count variable one of your data register and sum variable one of your data register. So here I've taken it as R0 and R1, and how many times you have added, you need to count it, because you will not know how many times you have performed. So for that, I'm having another register R2. So to get to know whether the operation has been completed or not. So this has to be done. So what we have to do? So we have to add this value R2 plus R1. Okay. So this sum is initialized to zero. So I'm starting with 1. So sum is now 0. So here my value, first value is now here. So with this, I will add this number. So, and I will update this value 1 in the sum itself. So then what will I do? I will increment this value R2. So that will become 2. So this sum and this R2 again can be added. And that result can again be put back in my sum. So how long I should continue until my R2 reaches this count value. Okay. So add the contents with immediate data and store the result in R2. Then you can subtract the content of R0 and R2 and store it in R4. I am checking whether all my counting is completed or not. If the result is not zero, then I have to go back and continue my addition operation. Otherwise, once all the operations are over, I can come out of the loop and I can add only the final result. So I'll just show you with an example. So I'm initializing my count as 5. R0, I'm loading this count. Sum is initialized to 0 and that is loaded in your R1 register, and R2 I'm initializing it to 1. Okay, so what we are doing, so it is 0, R2 is 1, so we are performing the operation addition and we are loading it in R1, and R2 is now incremented. So we are performing R0 minus R2. So the count is 5, 5 minus 2 is 3. So next again what we are doing, this sum is now added with your R2. What is your current R1? It is 1. Your R2 is 2. Okay. So these two are to be added and this result is updated in R1, which is 3. Then again what you are doing, you are incrementing your R2 and you are decrementing the count. So next what we should do, 1 plus 2 is over. With that result, you have to add this 3. So R1 is now 3. R2 is 3, so these two you are adding and this result is a 6. So 6 and your R2 is again incremented, you get 4. You are decrementing your R4 register, so how many times yet to complete, okay? Next 6 and 4 are added and you are getting this 10, and your R5 is now 5. So once the count is over, so we have not added the last value 5. So we have performed what? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. So plus 5 is yet pending. So what we are doing, after it has become 0, I'm adding R1 and R2 with R1 and I'm updating for the final value to be added. So this way you can perform the sum of n numbers. So this coding you have to try by yourself and you have to upload it in the classroom. We have circulated the output format. Okay, so for your output format, so here you can enter your coding, and for a sum of n numbers, register number is there, right? So you can take the register numbers 5th and 6th digit. Okay, so the count can be taken as that 2 digit. 5 and 6, you can take it as the count for each of you. And for the first part, addition of 7 numbers, you add your register numbers, individual digits. and to detect the number of positive and negative numbers, so assign any six numbers containing both positive and negative numbers and find out the positive number and negative number. For that, again you take the fifth and sixth digit and you add up and get the number of elements to be assigned to the array. Okay, please refer your output format. And for addition, take your register number. Apart from that, the consecutive other five register numbers you can take, and you can add all those numbers. So I will just tell you the array addition logic also. So sum of n numbers is clear. The next coding is array addition. So here what we have to do is you have to initialize the array variable for the input. Then you initialize your value as 0 in the register R0, because you are going to perform the addition. It is like a sum is equal to 0. And store the, load the starting address of the array in the register R1. So you have initialized the array in the data area. So that array's base address, you can load it into the R1. So load the count into the data register R2. So this count is your register number, fifth and sixth digit added together. So thus you can assign it in the register R2. In what you are doing, you are accessing the data from the base address and you move this to the R3 register. So here you have the sum, that is, which is 0. So this 0, you add the first data. Okay, store the result back in the first data itself. Next, what you have to do, you have to go to the next location. So for referring to the next location, what you do, you have to add this R1 with 4, because it's a program counter plus 4. So you have to add with 4 to point to the next data. Then what you have to do, you have to decrement the count value. So where is our count? It is in R2 register. So you have to decrement by 1 and you store the result back in the R2 itself. Continue these steps until it is not equal. Okay, if it is equal, then you can come out of the loop. So I've just shown one example here. So your count is 5. R2, we have loaded the count value, and R0 is the result, which is initially 0. And these are the address. For example, the address is this 8C9094989C, and it has these data. So what you have to do is you have to access the array data. Base address, should we do next? You have to decrement the count, as well as you have to increment the program counter by 4. Okay, so earlier the address was pointing to 28C, now the address is pointing to 290. So you have added with 4, and this decrement has done, so it will correspond to the next data. So the next data, if you access the content of R1, it will be pointing to your hex 34. So earlier you had a hex 12, so it is all hexadecimal number. So this hexadecimal number is added and you're getting this result. So continue until your R2 becomes 0. Okay, so you can use your first two coding as your reference and you can try this two codings. And you can submit in your output file format. So for your input, the corresponding output. Okay. And you can have your coding in this part, sum of n numbers in the array addition coding. Okay. Any doubts you have? Ma'am? Thank you. Any doubts you have, ma? Any doubts, ma?
Ma'am?
Ma'am?
Ma'am, I think ma'am has got some work in ARF work.
Okay, ma'am, okay. So I think we can close off if they don't have any doubts, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. I'll just give some instructions regarding the Viva.
Okay, ma'am.
See, I have already posted in the chat, and again I'll repeat it. For experiment 1, today at 4:15 p.m. Viva questions will be posted in the Google Classroom. Only 10 simple Viva questions for experiment 1 you have. So it will take some 10 to 15 minutes. And the deadline is kept till 8 p.m. Okay. And all the whole entire class should attend this Viva. They inform to the other batch students also. I think Pratipa ma'am have informed you this before through WhatsApp group. And next is submission of record. By this experiment 3 is over, and you should submit all your experiment before February 2nd. Okay, the deadline for experiment 1 and 2 is given as Jan 31st, and for experiment 3, the deadline is fixed as Feb 2. Okay, so you have to complete all the experiments before the deadline. So that your marks will not be reduced. And from next week onwards, regularly the Viva questions for the lab will be posted every Tuesday evening. Suppose you have lab on Wednesday and Friday, right? So Wednesday and Friday after completion, after doing all the experiments, I mean, you'll be working it out and filling the output sheet, right? The next week, Tuesday evening, you'll be given the Google form. Okay, so for that, for the experiment you did on the previous Wednesday and Friday. Okay, so after completing the Tuesday's Viva, then freshly you can start the next experiment on the Wednesday and Friday. Is it clear? Right, so like this week's experiment Viva, you will be attending next week Tuesday evening, as both batches have lab classes on different dates. So you will be given the Viva questions next Tuesday evening. All the entire class students should attend. Okay. Do you have any doubt in this?
See, also your coding, please keep it safely. Anytime we may ask for you to show the demo of what coding you have done. That will be also considered for some Viva. Okay, so please save your files and keep it ready. Don't copy, please do it by yourself. Okay, if you have any difficulties, please let us know.
Ma'am, attendance. Ma'am, roll number 16, Gautam.
Percent, ma'am.
36, Rajasaravanan.
Ma'am, present, ma'am. 36%, ma'am.
64
present, ma'am.
65
present, ma'am.
66
ma'am.
67?
Yes, ma'am.
68? 69?
69%, ma'am.
70?
70% ma'am.
71? 72?
72% ma'am.
73? 73? Absent, okay. 74?
74% ma'am.
75?
Present, ma'am.
I am going to mark you absent. You have not answered the ma'am's question, no? Where you went?
Ma'am, network problem, ma'am. I went out there.
We have not answered in the chat box also.
That's why, ma'am, I have poor network connection.
76?
76 present.
77?
77 present, ma'am.
78?
78 present, ma'am.
79?
79 present, ma'am.
80?
80 present, ma'am.
81?
81 present, ma'am.
82?
Present, ma'am.
83?
Present, ma'am.
84?
Yes, ma'am.
85?
85 present, ma'am.
87?
Present, ma'am.
88?
8 present, ma'am.
89?
Present, ma'am.
90?
90 present, ma'am.
91?
91 present, ma'am.
92?
92 present, ma'am.
94?
Present, ma'am.
95?
Present, ma'am.
96?
96 present, ma'am.
97?
97 present, ma'am.
Ma'am, I have completed taking the attendance.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am,
73 edo present, ma'am.
73. Balraj. Okay. Okay, ma'am. Okay. No absentees today. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Please attend the Viva. Thank you. Ma'am, Diana, ma'am. Stop recording, ma'am. Panniruvaanga nama pannuma.
Ma'am, nammalum pannikalam, ma'am. Onnum prachana illa.